Modern information transmission technology began with the telegraph, developed during the mid-19th century, which conveyed language content by converting it into electrical signals. The invention of the telephone made it possible for people to speak with each other over long distances. Technological advancement continued, with transmission technology moving from wired to wireless, and dramatic increases in transmission distance. In the modern age, as the world grew ever closer, one of Japan's national challenges in its move to modernization was the introduction of information communications technologies. That was the period in which the two companies which would later form Anritsu were born. Marconi succeeded in sending the first wireless communications in 1895. In the same year, Keizaburo Ishiguro and Kamataro Sugiyama, technical officers in the Ministry of Communications and Transportation, founded Seki Sansha and began manufacturing wired communications equipment. Realizing the future potential of wireless communications, Tsunejiro Annaka, an assistant at Tokyo Imperial University, established Annaka Electric Company in 1900. It engaged in research and development of primary wireless transmission equipment components. An Annaka-type induction coil was used in the Type 36 radio telegraph that sent the enemy ships in sight message in the Russo-Japanese War in 1905. In 1908, Seki Sansha became Kyoritsu Electric Company, and it began manufacturing products such as automatic telephones and switches. It went on to manufacture automatic tabletop telephone units, becoming a pioneer in Japan's budding telecommunications industry. Annaka Electric Company manufactured the TYK wireless telephone, which was successful in the world's first commercial viability testing of wireless communications. It continued to leave its mark on communications history with milestones such as the production of the first Japanese radio receiver. In 1929, the world found itself in the midst of a financial crisis. Business conditions were poor for both Kyoritsu Electric and Annaka Electric. The two merged in 1931 to form Anritsu Electric Corporation. Using the technologies it had built up in both wired and wireless communications, Anritsu Electric responded to the needs of the times by manufacturing devices such as direction finders and underwater receivers. It also developed the magnetic sound recorder, the forerunner of the tape recorder, and produced Japan's first TV broadcast transmitter. In 1945, Japan was defeated in World War II. Anritsu Electric looked for a foothold in the private sector market, but it was unable to prevail in the post-war turmoil. Covered by the Enterprise Reorganization Act, it relaunched itself in 1950. The new Anritsu Electric rebuilt its business operations, developing and manufacturing devices such as radar equipment, marine radios, and public telephones. It was especially active in developing new models of public telephones. In 1960, the number of public telephones installed in Japan passed 100,000 units, and Anritsu Electric contributed greatly to the spread of this means of communication. It also cultivated the measuring instrument market. In line with the Nippon Telegraph and Telephone Public Corporation's network expansion plans, it developed and delivered various measuring instruments. The wireless business market also grew. With the rapid proliferation of television sets following the start of TV broadcasting, Anritsu Electric developed measuring equipment for microwave circuits, field strength meters, and signal generators. Through its contributions to Japan's information communications infrastructure, it established its position as Anritsu, the measuring instrument company. In 1961, Anritsu Electric opened its Atsugi factory. The new facility not only expanded the company's production system, but also operated as an eco-factory, introducing improvements to air, water and noise pollution prevention and wastewater processing. In 1964, Tokyo hosted the Olympic Games. Along with the whole Japanese economy, Anritsu Electric went into a period of rapid growth. In 1969, technologies allowing access to space were developed. That year also marked the start of the digitalization of communications with a technology called PCM. Anritsu Electric developed measuring instruments for this PCM technology, helping support the dawn of digital communications. The company's overseas business also witnessed growth, with Anritsu Electric starting exports of coin-operated public telephones to Telecom Australia in 1971. In 1977, it received orders for 30,000 units. With regard to the measurement instruments business, it received orders from America's AT&T for microwave radio test sets in 1979. Anritsu Electric's technologies and products had crossed the oceans and were now being used in countries around the world. Go up high on the London Eye. Oh, London, we love you. During this period, Anritsu Electric expanded the scope of its business to include traffic information systems, telecontroller equipment, vending machines, and much more. Western nights just made for you. It also established a strong foothold in the food industry with its auto check weighers and weight check and price labeling equipment. With the 1980s came a shift in information transmission to the use of optical fibers. Anritsu Electric led the world in developing an optical time domain reflector meter, which could detect the locations of optic fiber troubles. It also established a firm brand position as Anritsu, the optics leader, with its development of optical spectrum analyzers and optical power meters, using Anritsu Electric's revolutionary measuring technologies. In the wireless communications field, it developed the Inmarsat ship earth station equipment and color radar, improving safety at sea. Due to these cutting-edge technological strengths and its expanding global business, Anritsu Electric changed its name in 1985. It would now forge a new course as the Anritsu Corporation. In the same year, Anritsu established Tohoku Anritsu as its public telephone manufacturing base. The overseas public telephone business remained brisk, and telephones were exported to countries such as Australia and Mexico. In 1995, Anritsu celebrated its 100th anniversary and standardized the names of its overseas companies. Based on a one-country, one-company system, it reorganized itself for the upcoming 21st century. As the 1990s came to a close, the tide of high-speed, high-volume communications continued to accelerate. Anritsu developed and manufactured the Mini OTDR, which is a compact-size optical time domain reflectometer, optical spectrum analyzers, high-speed devices, and optical devices. Its SONET SDH analyzer, which supported international digital communication standards, was especially well received in the market. That was also the era in which Chinese business saw tremendous growth. Anritsu exported IC card-operated public telephones, measuring instruments for digital and optical networks, radio monitoring systems, and automatic combination wires. These formed Anritsu's business foundation. The start of the 21st century. The new millennium was ushered in by revolutions in digital mobile phone technologies. In 2001, Japan led the world in launching a third-generation mobile phone service. Anritsu rolled out measuring instruments that supported this new 3G technology on a global scale. By supporting the development of mobile phones, from mere telephones to information terminals, which could also be used for a variety of data communications purposes, and even to watching television broadcasts, Anritsu cemented its position as a 3G leader. It also developed measuring instruments for high-speed devices. Its wide base station construction and maintenance handheld measuring instruments lineup extended to everything from antennas and cable measurement to signal analysis. The name Anritsu became synonymous with the revolutionary efficiency advancements these brought about in fieldwork. In 2004, as information communications networks were growing more advanced and complex, Anritsu made its first forays into the service assurance business, making possible the monitoring of communications networks and real-time data collection and analysis. In its industrial automation business, Anritsu developed an X-ray inspection system. It established a manufacturing plant in Thailand, and through its rich and varied lineup, began supporting the safety and reliability of food products around the world. Anritsu's information communications business began offering system solutions in the field of network application bandwidth control and video signal distribution. Anritsu's roots have extended unbroken right up to today. In 2010, information communication systems entered a new age. Smartphones began seeing explosive growth, and LTE, which allows optic fiber levels of communication speed on mobile terminals, was commercially deployed. Anritsu was the first company in the world to develop a test system, which is essential for LTE terminal protocol conformance testing. Its measurement solutions, based on the technologies it has established through its work with 3G mobile phone services, cover everything from LTE terminal development and manufacturing to base station construction and maintenance and service quality assurance. Anritsu is supporting the advance of LTE, which could become a true global standard. As the digital shift in electronic equipment progresses, Anritsu continues to provide measuring instruments for the development and manufacturing of the wireless communication devices, which are the heart of such equipment. In this way, Anritsu is supporting quality improvements in digital products. Anritsu also has a wide lineup of measurement solutions for optical networks and optical devices, which form the core of communication services for high-speed, high-volume content such as video and music. Anritsu also offers measurement software supporting the use of IP in electronic devices. Its total solutions are assisting the creation of the broadband networks that are the foundation of LTE. Information terminals, automobiles, appliances, power networks, factory automation. Today, information networks are being used to seamlessly connect people with people with equipment, and equipment with equipment, creating new values for society. We are entering an age in which everyone will have access to rich, easy-to-use information communication services. Anritsu will continue building on its century-spanning efforts to develop reliable and robust information communications technologies that will help to create the society of tomorrow.